Sam.
Cam.
Sam and Cam.
Ich step on him.
We're back.
He's dead now. Fuck, not quite far enough. Ooh, I successfully dodge rolled out of that.
Yeah, you just need to dodge twice. It's over. And time it right, obviously. Oh, there's a movie coming out. Or I don't know if it's coming out or not, because this bus stop doesn't exactly update its advertisements. Might be coming out. Yeah, I don't know if you heard of it. I saw an advertisement for a movie called The Rhythm Section.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just like a woman standing in darkness holding a gun, and it says The Rhythm Section. And it's like this poster accurately like describes anyone's reaction to having to play through Atlantica and Kingdom Hearts 2 in the Rhythm Section.
You should take a picture of that and post that as a meme.
I'm just gonna like find the poster and Google it. Yeah.
What kind of name for a movie is that?
Honestly, I mean, it's not the name that's weird. It's like, why is a movie with that name, why does that have a woman with a fucking gun in darkness as a fucking... What does that have to do with anything?
Dangerous games. Good.
Did Goofy just say hell yeah?
Yeah! I like how much Goofy just enjoys Kingdom Hearts and the things that happen in this franchise.
This ship runs on happy faces after all.
That's true.
Anyway, the reason why I thought there's a section was because of, like, that's basically what it's like to dodge his bone arrow.
Or block his dash slashes.
Yeah. They like Sora gets hurt when they push him as if he takes damage. He doesn't take damage. He doesn't actually take damage though, so it's pretty much just like yes. So it's pretty much just like Sora just gets pushed and he's like, oh, hey, alright.
Alright, I'm gonna try to do something kind of dangerous.
Do limit right now, honestly.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, you glide away from him so you wouldn't actually kill Donald. In fact, if you could do that again, maybe that would make Whirligoof more useful.
What do you mean, do that again?
Like, glide away before you start the limit. Like, you could start the limit when he does the unlockable.
Yeah. After all, Goofy is alive more often.
Yes!
Oh boy.
If you can do it again. Do it again, do it again. You have to drive after this, so. Revert in Kiraga.
Fuck.
Heal. Oh, it's the tag one. You gotta drive.
Shit.
We have it, though.
Yeah, I think that would... It sort of requires a good... The only thing with that strat is that it requires a good pattern in the first two phases.
Okay, hold on a second. Let me think. Go to the Moogle. Yeah, go to Moogle, go to Synthesize, go to Creations. Can you make an upgraded elixir? Sorry, Gem.
Synthesize?
Yes. Okay, so you have another Mega Elixir, you put that in there. And then... Let's see, here's what I was thinking. So put those both those Mega Elixirs in. Unfortunately, you don't have more Serene Gems. Unless, can you make a Serene Gem, actually?
How do I do that again?
Well, see if you have Serene Gem somewhere here.
A Serenity Crystal. No. Don't think so.
Go to Mithril Shard. Can you upgrade Mithril Shard? Energy Shard too. Alright, synthesize. No. Okay. Never mind then. Well, okay, so maybe what you can do, actually, is replace... I don't know if you want... Do you find the elixirs particularly more useful than the potions besides the extra HP?
They can be useful because I get my magic back.
Okay, because what I was thinking was replace them with the mega potions so that you guarantee Donald's alive.
Wait, how does that guarantee he's alive?
Because mega potion heals your entire party.
Oh, okay.
And mega the reason why I put the mega elixir there is because it elixirs your entire party.
Yeah.
Like, you already have the mega potion.
The thing is, I don't have... Well,
you can just take some from other people. Yeah. I mean, you do have mega potions already here. I forgot about that. Put another mega elixir in on the bottom, I guess. Right.
I mean, I think this is fine. Having one elixir isn't bad.
Yeah. It's up to you, but this is... So basically when you start using mega potion, every time you use a mega potion, everyone's alive. And even if your MP doesn't come back, like, your MP recharge fast enough for you to get more limits out.
Yeah.
So, like, pretty much Mega Potion.
Especially because the reason why this is good is because Duck Flare lasts just long enough that when it ends, his limit ends.
Yeah.
So,
and then you can do a combo.
Position myself where he is, combo him. In that time, I get my MP back because of Ultima Weapon.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah, this should be fine.
Okay, go back out and save it. We're finally breaking through, Sam.
I think that was a major breakthrough.
That was the last step. That was the last step. That's actually the last step.
And I've got enough resources to need to do that 5 times if necessary.
Look, dude, if you were driving your motorcycle and you saw Donald, would you hit him?
No. What the fuck does that mean?
I wouldn't either. I'm just asking.
Fucking, hey, look, Donald, duck, I'm going to run him over.
You know, if you try to run over Donald with your motorcycle, he'd like stretch his legs such that you go under him because he's a cartoon character.
Or, you know, because the plot hates him, he would just scream and then you pancake him. But he doesn't die, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, well, that's what's happening here.
It depends on what's funnier and what the plot of the cartoon
is. That's what's happening here. Kingdom Hearts is an action game where Donald and Goofy just die all the time while Sora does everything. Unless you're playing Kingdom Hearts 1, in which case Donald and Goofy are like the ones carrying you the whole time.
That trade.
If you landed a little bit earlier or something.
I think if I reacted a little faster. I actually wanted the thing to explode. Like, I wanted to roll into it. And I think Goofy blocked it. No, right. I keep forgetting about that. Thankfully, I recovered in time.
I mean, you know, we almost had... The series was almost about Donald.
What, Kingdom Hearts or Mickey?
Yes, the whole reason we had Sora was because half the development team wanted Donald and half of it wanted Sora. I mean, Mickey. But imagine Donald being a character, huh? Imagine that?
That would be a very different game. For sure.
Like, for one thing, Antiform would just be the default. Because he's just mad all the time.
Antiform Donald would be funny.
Oh. Okay. No, he's not going to do the command log until phase 2, right?
Probably not. Then again, you know, this is the lighter version, so...
No, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Like, I think he definitely doesn't do until phase 2 until the fighter version. I think he's too busy doing the lighter.
I suppose that's one way of looking at it.
But, you know, still be scared if he jumps on top of you, like...
Oh my god.
you know how Terra got all these new moves?
How?
Think about it, it's been 10 years since Birth by Sleep, right? Closer, so more than 10 years actually. Like 11 years. You just gotta attack him and then you get your HP back.
Well, he just has to be open is the problem. Whatever.
Yeah, so it's been... And Terra is just alone in the Keyblade graveyard as a Keyblade armor with nothing to do. What do you think he does to pass the time, Sam?
Just Keyblade glide around?
No! He plays command board! He got all these cool things for the command board!
But see, if he played command board, he could get out of this place.
No, command board is just a board game, my dude. It's not a different world. You can play it at any save point. In fact, I think you can play it at any point in period. I don't remember.
He's facing away, I think. Got him!
You did it again! Back off. Oh my god! It's
over. Is that the point of those?
That's not the point of those, but yes, you can reflect the shots, and if he is present, they go towards him.
What the fuck is happening?
You're actually dealing with his set play. That's what's happening. You weren't locked onto him.
Right.
If soft lock, like, it's not that reliable.
Man.
So he literally just crossed you up.
Why does that happen?
You're just too close, Sam. Like, the back roll on that is a good idea, too, because that should give you a lot of distance. Walking back probably doesn't give you enough distance or time.
That's why I hate that. It's like...
Rhythm section.
Dodge
night.
God knew that was coming.
Yeah, you saw. He stopped in front of you. You're like, okay, yeah, that's...
Fuck. I didn't save that time.
Oh. Two finishers this time. Because the third one doesn't hit.
I blocked game. What? Oh, he was doing the whip. I was like, what attack was that?
He was doing the Johnny test.
He's doing the whip. He's doing the whip. Oh, speaking of Johnny Test, did you know there is a Johnny Test reboot?
Yes, that's why it was on the mind enough for that joke.
And did you know that the reboot looks exactly the same?
Yeah, I might as well just see a new season.
Yeah. The rumor is there's going to be a Tiny Mon Go episode, among other things.
A what?
A Tiny Mon. You know the Tiny Mon episode?
Oh.
They're making a Tiny Mon Go episode because, you know, the show doesn't have a single original idea. It's just riffing off of everything that exists ever.
Man, the first season was actually pretty good.
The first season was good because they didn't use the whip sound effect and it was hand animated.
And also, like, good. They actually had good jokes.
Yeah.
Although, like, I don't know if you ever realized this.
I've had arguments with people where it's like, what do you mean Johnny Test was bad? I like season one pretty good. And it's like, yeah, season one was good. And then they ruined it.
I don't know if you realize this, but I don't know what it's become since then, really. But when I first watched season one, I literally was just like, this is just a gender flip that should laugh.
Yeah, except it's not about. It's like a gender flip deck lab where
and the protagonist is also flips.
Yeah, it's a gender flip Dexter's lab where the main protagonist is.
Yeah,
that's pretty much what it is. And like a larger supporting cast of recurring characters.
Dial M for monkey.
You know what's really surprising though?
What?
With all of the shit that Johnny Test riffs off of, I'm surprised there isn't like you know fucking Garfield Kart. Why isn't there a Johnny Test kart racing game? They literally had an episode about that.
I don't remember that much about Johnny Test, don't you?
The only reason I know is because it was on all the fucking time. So oftentimes I had no choice but to watch it
on Cartoon Network.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing, Sam. I never had cable. So, the few times I've watched Cartoon Network was when my TV was, like, somehow illegally getting someone else's cable or something like that.
I didn't know that was a thing.
It was, like, basically, I don't remember the exact details, but we definitely had someone else's cable, and it was definitely a wire that was coming in through the window.
Sounds wild, fam.
But that ended pretty much, like, I stopped being able to watch Cartoon Network shows on Cartoon Network pretty much right when Johnny Test stopped being on Kids LAV. So I never actually saw the Cartoon Network seasons of Johnny Test. And every show I kept up with, I had to watch online.
Hmm. Wow, he actually did the normal fucking attack.
I think it's the first time he started with that all day.
Yeah. Like, that's the attack he's supposed to start with.
I mean,
well,
no.
No, not supposed to, but it's like, that's it's, like the one it's, that's like...
It's the normal attack for phase one. Like, yeah. Surprisingly, he never starts with the whip, which is another normal phase one attack. Instead... He does, like, most of the time, he does Command Lock, which is rare in Phase 1. Cannon, also rare in Phase 1. And Kiba Glider, which isn't even Phase 1.
Ha!
Oh, he does start with a punch sometimes, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's the one. All right, Nomura. Time to make the villain of your big Disney crossover. What's he gonna look like? And Nomura makes Ansem. God, I love Ansem.
He's just an idiot, but he's a lovable idiot.
He's probably the most, surprisingly, the most Disney-esque of the villains, because he's such an entertaining villain.
So I guess you could say Nomura nailed him then.
Yeah, but he looks like a Final Fantasy villain, which is like the magic of Kingdom Hearts. You knew it. It's the magic of Kingdom Hearts. Like, you have a character that looks like a Final Fantasy villain. He acts like a Disney villain. He even died in a Disney way. Like, come on, he died because he's dumb. He made a mistake, and then he just gets. Disintegrated by pure light.
Mm.
And he covers his eyes as if the worst thing it's gonna do is blind him. It does way more than that. Nice. That was Goofy, wasn't it?
Yeah, it looked like it reflected way too early.
Like, Goofy was literally, walking towards him with his shield up.
He was being a bro.
That's the attack one.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Now.
Stinger.
Post's clip of Lingering Will fight.
That was interesting. Generally does not do that.
Just post clips of like any game at all, except Smash, like action games, racing games, whatever, and be like, call me when Smash Ultimate has a clip with this much drip.
Wow. Fuck.
You should have just healed immediately.
Yeah, I don't know why I waited. Damn, that was a really good run, too.
We're still going to time.
Yeah, we're fine.
It's 6-on-6. That's the Marvel Universe. Kingdom Hearts confirmed. Kingdom Hearts confirmed for what? For Smash.
Kingdom Hearts confirmed for Marvel. They're making a Kingdom Hearts movie.
Did you see that Onion article on
that
link?
Actually, I think the funniest thing about that joke is that, like, that makes it seem like... Like, that's such a big deal. Like, oh, Marvel Kingdom Hearts, when, like, we're just... It's not a question of if anymore. It's a question of when. It's like, it's guaranteed that this is happening. We just don't know when it's happening. So...
When they run out of Pixar movies, basically. Imagine we unironically just get a Chicken Little.
I wouldn't be mad.
I wouldn't be mad either.
And then Chicken Little just fucking rolls up and he's like, yo! My dude!
It's my boy! It's my sword! Everyone else in the world is like, who the hell? And he's like, Chicken Little's just like, this is literally the only person that has ever respected me.
Watch like the image of that become like a reaction image.
And Sora just like looks at everybody else in that world and is just like, hey, this place is kind of messed up.
When my parents complain about my latest hyperfixation.
This is literally the only person in the world who has ever respected me. Yeah, Sora just sees everyone else in the world and is like, these people are kind of really messed up. And then for once, Donald lets him break the order and just take Chicken Little with him as a summon again, because those people are not... That is not a good place to grow up.
Yeah, holy shit. I think that's part of what's frustrating about the movie, is that, like, literally every character, except for Chicken Little, is a fucking ass.
Yeah, because they tried to be edgy like DreamWorks, and then missed the point. I think the CEO at the time literally said to the people making the movie that we're gonna out DreamWorks,
which is fucking like it's just one of the silliest things anyone knew. Actually, I think that was during like the brief kind of dark age period.
That was Chicken Little was that dark age
where the only 2D animated movie they made in that span was Princess and the Frog. It's like the mid to late 2000s.
Oh, thanks, Donald.
He literally came back just to heal me and then died again. What a bro. Oh, I think this is going to be the one where he starts doing the... Oh, no, you're not. I thought he was going to start, like, barrel rolling at me. Or actually, isn't that an aileron roll? How's that?
I think it's, like, a really small barrel roll, because... He's not corkscrewing. His trajectory actually is changing. So that would make it a barrel roll, but it's not as wide as a regular barrel roll is. But I think the reason why actual barrel rolls are that wide is because it's literally impossible to get one that narrow in real life.
Yeah, seriously. You have to have incredible control of any vehicle.
And you need to not be human, because that G-force is gonna, like, rip your head off.
Yeah.
It's already, like, a huge pain whenever a roller coaster gets hit.
Yeah.
This is the good pattern.
Yes.
As long as you keep dodging it, your the phase is basically home free. Home free Bogart.
My favorite King of Fighters character.
Home free Bogart. I mean,
it's Terry's third brother.
I mean, Terry does look like a baseball player, and he does play baseball. So, yeah, why not?
Yep, it's coming. Oh, but Donald's dead. If he's not alive when...
You can do Mega Potion. Back,
yeah.
Now.
Okay,
it's fine. Just make sure you get the combo after the combo, after his combo. There.
Shit. Oh, this is okay. Good, 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 good.
You're gonna have to do the Mega Potion again.
Yeah.
Magic one, so you have a drive to limit. That's really the strat. Just keep doing the Mega Potion. You just have to be consistent about getting the combo. Like, he always slashes through you at the end. So, and since you're invincible during that time, you don't have to dodge it. You just kind of have to follow him on the last hit.
Yeah, I don't know why I was like dodge roll.
Yeah, literally, you don't even have to move. You literally don't have to move.
What? I'd roll.
two finishes. Oh. Oh no. What the? What?
I mashed. I did a third one.
No, but like, the weird thing was the fact that the third one actually did hit him, and the fact that he was doing like a descending whip attack.
Yeah, I don't know. This boss is still fucking weird.
Look, if this boss was completely predictable, it wouldn't be nearly as fun.
True.
Like, that's actually like, Uh-oh. I remember the combat designer for God Hand, nice. What said that is just like, it's like not even fun if a boss has like a completely predictable pattern. There's gotta be something there for you to like actually react to. And that's why God Hand has RNG in the patterns, but it's not like Birth by Sleep or anything, it's just, it's stuff that you can just react to. Wow, this is a completely predictable pattern.
It, you know why it is? It's because I usually do not get far in the things where
command lock?
He starts with a command lock, so this is sort of new. But I like it, though, because I'm getting practice dodging that. And I think I realized that the actual animation of him doing the attack is pretty reactable, because it's an overhead.
Yeah, he dashes and then jumps and then does that. And it's not even that fast.
No, it's not. You just have to see it.
The dash is fast, but
wow.
Then he jumps.
That and killed me only because he was moving slowly towards me, which I don't think I've ever seen him do.
He does move slowly forward. He does that a lot, actually. It's just most of the time you're in blocking him in range, and if you're close enough to him, he doesn't really do that much. Look, dude, you're getting better at, like, all of his patterns. And your magic's back. You're doing it, Sam.
Just wish I could put it all together. That's all.
Well, you know what? You're doing a better job putting this fight together than most people have putting the series we fought together.
Hey. Which is a much easier task. Really ain't all that crazy.
Oh, never mind.
Goofy!
Dude, the thing I was gonna tell you about, you proved it for me, so now I can tell you about it.
Oh, okay.
I was saying that I don't actually know if the last hit of his knuckle combo is blockable. But you proved yes it is. Because you noticed every other time you never actually blocked it.
Yeah.
You just had your invincibility from the previous block. Imagine like a fighting game character with command locking, but like the only thing he commands lock is sweep. And imagine how many people would like lose because of that.
That's some ghost ball shit.
You gonna have sweeps and ghost balls? Also, don't talk about that. Don't talk about that, son. Don't talk about this. You know. But yes. Do you know about stop using sweep?
Yes.
What is that?
I mean, it's just a phrase people say when someone's spamming.
Well, do you know, like, the original context?
No.
It's Iori. Iori Yagami. Oh, the KOF. He's like consistently top tier.
Yeah.
But the thing is that like the thing that like makes a lot of like newcomers lose with him anyway, which is weird because he's not even like a hard character to use. Is because for some reason, like almost every Iori player, like the ones that like don't know what they're doing, like you know, most of them, they just use the sweep. They see a sweep that has like such a huge range, and then they just use it all the time. But it's such a ridiculously terrible move. Not in every KOF game. But it's like, even if you land it, it's like, okay, you get a hard knockdown. What are you going to do now? You know? Use anything else. So, like...
I guess he just doesn't really have, like a reset or vortex game.
No, he does. Just not from that sweep. You know? That's how bad it is.
Wow.
The end lag on the sweep is... Because he, like, does a sort of, like, crouching drop kick.
Why don't you do that?
So it's like, you know, that... No, it's not a good sweep. Oh, he's gonna do it.
Oh.
Well, he tried to do it.
He doesn't always do it.
No, but, like, when he did, like, two jumps, I'm like, okay, he's gonna try to do it. But I think he just didn't land close enough four times. So... Yeah, so, like... on, like, multiple SRK wiki pages for, Iori Yagami, it just says, stop using sweep. I think, like... One of them even uses, like, word art to stop using sweep. Like, it doesn't even have a description for Iori. It's just, you click the page, and then you just see it in big word art, stop using sweep, and you have to, like, scroll down to get to the actual character information.
Wow, that was unfortunate.
Okay, do you know about Million Arthur Arcana Blood?
No.
Oh, you don't?
No.
Okay, so Million Arthur Arcana Blood is a fighting game... A 2D anime fighter made by Square Enix. It is a spin-off of their mobile gacha game called Million Arthur, which Million Arthur.
Like the name, Arthur.
Yeah, yes. That's the name of the gacha game, Million Arthur.
Interesting.
It is so clearly like just taking an idea from Fate to its logical conclusion. And The premise of Million Arthur is that, like, there is literally a million different versions of King Arthur, and that's what all the characters are. And so, like, instead of, like, having actual names, they're just called, like, Thief Arthur, or, like, Mage Arthur, or something.
Okay.
There are other characters, though. Like, that's just most of the main characters, like, they're the Arthurs. And it's like, and I don't even think that you try to bring it into the West.
Yeah, that does sound very,
But it is a Square Enix game. And so they made it actually does do well enough in Japan, somehow, that they got spin-offs. And, so they made a fighting game called Million Arthur Arcana Blood, which is actually a good game. That's not surprising you hadn't heard of it, because it's, like, one of the good... One of the only, like, true traditional anime fighters right now. Because, like, everything else is being either a tag fighter or starting to get more footsies-based.
Mm-hmm.
Alright,
I think this might be the last attempt of this episode.
And so it has guest characters. One of the guest characters is Lee's from Trials of Mana. And this was actually before they even announced that they were going to remake Trials of Mana, so it was really weird that she was there. But it's like, okay, whatever. It's another Square Enix character. But then they added as a cross promotion with SNK, they added Iori to Million Arthur Arcana Blood. So he's just in an anime fighter now. And he has nothing to do with anything, he's just there. And SNK in turn, they got the Thief Arthur for SNK Heroines.
Interesting.
And I think Million Arthur Arcana Blood actually did end up coming out in the West. Despite Million Arthur itself not coming out, because, like, Fighting Game Fan is actually, like, Million Arthur Arcana Blood. That's the whip.
That's so weird that it just randomly runs up and does that sometimes. Alright, I lied. Because that attempt was fast. Let's do one more.
Yeah. So the Mizumi Wiki, I don't know if you know the Mizumi Wiki.
No.
Okay, the Mizumi Wiki is like SRK, except for anime fighters.
Makes sense.
And it's like, you know, people like to act like SRK is like the be-all end-all of fighting games.
Oh, good God, no. Fuck.
And it's like, nah.
It's very Street Fighter-centric. I mean, that just goes back to the name of the...
Yeah, they only do, like...
They're better than event hubs, I'd say, but not by much, nor is that saying much.
Yeah, but I'm purely talking about the wiki here. The wiki does cover a lot of games, some obscure, some old, but they're like Capcom and SNK games.
Yeah.
It doesn't really cover, like, anime fighters unless it's, like, Guilty Gear or Blaze Blue.
Yeah, like a big one.
And
in DBFC.
And it doesn't even really do that well. If you want real Guilty Gear information, you go to Dustloop. And if you want... I think Dustloop also has Blaze Blue. And if you want, like, any other anime fighter, you go to Mizumi Wiki. And so... They had a page for Million Arthur Arcana Blood, and they have a page on Iori in that game. And the description of it is like, it's talking about how great of a fighter Iori was in King of Fighters, and just like how he's so powerful, he can like win against any character. He has all the tools he needs, and he says, but unfortunately, Iori could not stop using Sweep. So he went into a game where sweeps are special cancelable.
That's amazing. That's really fucking good. That's really good.
Yep.
Nice meme. That's like a joke we would make in a fighting game.
I should show you some of the SRK wiki pages. I've shown you some before, like, but you know, a lot of that was back in the Skype era. So I'll just show you again. Damn, the Skype era.
Kinda. Yeah.
I hated that era, by the way. I only install Skype for you guys. I hate Skype. I hate every man of you in Skype. I'm so glad we're not using Skype.
It used to be better. That's all I'll say.
Dude, I was coming into Skype from AIM. It was never good enough for me.
No, I mean, I understand that, but... You know, the real irony is that everyone else used to use AIM. I mean, I didn't, but, like, the Enigma, Danny TS, everyone used to use AIM. I don't remember why Skype was a thing. It might have been only because I used it.
Yeah, I wasn't even that group in the Skype. I was talking about Snaz.
Yeah, which is honestly an even longer era, to be honest. Because there was a long period where you were on... The only Skype chat we really were in was Snaz. And then I added you to People Talk later.
In That didn't happen in Skype. I never was part of people talking Skype.
Oh, well, you know what? I might be thinking of a time when, like, I think when you found out.
When I, what's it called? I hijacked your computer.
Wow.
Or rather, Aaron hijacked your computer. And I recognized the names on the screen. And I was like, oh. I mean, that's a different story. But yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, we should end it.
See you guys next time.